Clear team roles and permissions are essential for smooth operations. In this video, I'll show you how to set up team members in the supplier portal and customize what they can view and manage. You'll learn how to match permissions and set up email notifications to ensure customer messages don't go unanswered. Now let's start by accessing your account settings. Click your profile icon in the top right corner and then select Account Settings to reach the account management page. Here's where you'll see your whole team at a glance. The page displays key information like email addresses, account holders, account types with their login access, and notification preferences. Use the checkboxes to see who gets which updates. This way you know exactly who's notified and when. When you click right next to the team member's email on the drop-down arrow, you'll see important security details like their last login time or their two-factor authentication status. This helps you monitor account security and keep your business protected. Are you ready to add a new team member? Then click Add a new account profile in the top right corner. Remember, you'll need admin access for this. So if you are not an admin and, for example, have operations access, you won't be able to add new contacts. Now let's walk through it together and add this new user. Enter their email address and name. Then add their position and phone number. Then decide if they need portal access by toggling Allow Login. Without this, they'll only receive email notifications. So for this video, let's assume you want to give them access. Now comes the important part, selecting their account type. Select Administration for full access and user management, Finance for only viewing financial and payment information, Operations for managing products and bookings, or Guides for handling bookings. This means that depending on the access type, a user might not be able to access a certain part of the supplier portal. For example, if you give finance access only, the user will only see the finance tab. Or if they have guide access, they will only see availability and bookings. So setting the right access is critical. Here we'll select operations. Next, decide if they should receive email notifications and customize them. Think about what updates they need. Do they need accounting updates? Should they receive booking or review notifications? Or should they only be receiving customer messages? Select the ones that are the most accurate to their role. In our example, we'll enable notifications for bookings and customer questions. For customer questions, keep your email up to date and active as it's used by our customer care team and customers via the relay system. Not responding could lead to lower review ratings, increased cancellations, and lost revenue. Only one email address can receive customer questions. So to handle inquiries by multiple team members, use an email group for notifications without enabling portal login. This way your whole team can respond efficiently. If everything looks good, do the same for marketing emails and click Add a new account profile. Your new team member will receive an email to activate their account. They simply need to confirm the email address to finalize and get access. If you need to modify existing users, just click the three dots next to their name to update permissions, change notifications, or remove access. And that's it. Good account management keeps your team efficient and your customers happy. So to recap, make sure you set up team roles and permissions accurately to avoid login issues, match permissions with each team member's responsibilities in your business, enable the right notifications to ensure customer messages reach the appropriate people. And finally, regularly review, update settings, and remove users as your team and business needs change. For more guidance, keep watching our video series or visit supply.getyourguide.support for additional resources.